Hey guys.
Hey guys.
Yo.
So,
how's it going?
Let's just chat for a minute.
So take a look at my makeup today.
Isn't this awesome?
Mostly Synergence products.
Love it.
Love it.
Love it.
So, anyways, check out this background. I thought the lighting would be great. To do this part of the video real quick. I just wanted to, I don't know why I'm really showing up before, but introduce this video. I'm really sore. My legs are sore. I can't really focus. My legs are sore because I did a workout today. I did some cardio. Anyways, and there's kids laughing behind me. Kids laughter. Holy cow, what is wrong with me? I didn't have but like one cup of coffee today. Just one. One little cup of coffee. So anyway, today, this video, I better start introducing this video. We're 1 minute in and we haven't even started talking about what we're gonna do. So this video, obviously, if you can't tell by the title, is gonna be about foundation. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about foundations. Well, mostly about Synergence foundations, of course. So yeah. Later on in this video, I will be talking about it. I'll also be trying on my old foundations. I haven't done this. I haven't worn these foundations in forever. Foundations that just were either too dark or just didn't work or I didn't like. I don't know. and I just kept for whatever reason. But I'll be showing lots of pictures. I'll be talking about stuff. Anyways, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna section off my face, and you'll see here in a minute, and I'm going to put in different sections the foundations that I have. I have three foundations, three old foundations, and one which is my Make Sense foundation that I will be putting on to show you guys the difference and show you how much it changes my face. If you can see the difference between the foundations. My foundation actually is yellow looking. It looks yellow when I put it on. But once I've got it set in and I've got it applied all over my face, it's right now. Does this look yellow? No, it looks like it actually fits to my face really well. So I'm really excited to talk about it and show more about my foundation, you guys. Like, this is awesome. I've never really found a foundation. Like, I can't believe I even have a foundation that looks yellow when I put it on, but fits so well. It's amazing. It's amazing. So, and it feels really great on my face. So, alright, I'm gonna quit gabbing. I'm gonna quit jabbing on. What am I talking? So if this is something that you are interested in watching, you know, the difference between the foundations that I have and listening a little bit more about some Synergence foundation, stick around and watch some more. Like and subscribe if you'd like for me. So thank you so much. Bye, I'll see you in a minute. Hey guys, Rebecca back, and just letting you guys know that we're gonna go ahead and jump into it and get started. So as you can see, I've already got my face sectioned off, and I'm gonna go ahead and start. The way I wanna do it is, we're gonna do Rimmel up top here, then Maybelline, was a Superstay makeup. Hey, can you chill that out? Thank you. Rimmel here. Superstay makeup here, Maybelline. Then we'll do Maybelline Fit Me up here. Oops. Fit Me, and then the Make Sense Foundation, Anti-Aging, Advanced Anti-Aging Make Sense Foundation, porcelain color right here. So anyways, so that's how we're going to do it. I will show you guys a picture right here. I'll show you also a couple pictures of what inspired me to try this myself with my foundations. But the foundations that I have that I'm showing you guys, a lot of them have oils in it, and it's just showing you which foundations have a lot of oil that's going onto your skin. And out of the four, these two had the least amount.
Yes, this does have some oil in it. It's because it is advanced anti-aging, which is more so meant for drier skin, which is fine because I have dry skin anyway. So there is a little bit of oil in it, and you'll see that in that picture. And this had a very little bit of oil in it too. So anyways, oh yeah, and it says oil-free. Oh yeah, right. Also, just going by the phone. I'm sorry, I'm using the. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I think I got it. So that's one section down, and boy, do I look great. This is an old foundation I had forever ago. I don't know. I think I bought it for theater, thinking it was good. Get Maybelline. 24-hour wear, I can tell you this is not true. I'm wearing pink champagne right now. I was wearing Aussie Rose and Coralina that went with my headband, but I decided to change it to something a little more, what do you call it? Neutral for this video, so it's not like so bright in your face. We're doing a test right here. Ugh, already I'm just not, I'm not taking this at all. I'm not liking the color. I'm not liking the way it feels. Oh, maybe I'm just so used to mine right now. It's a practically full bottle, so you can tell I either lost it or I just never used it because I didn't like it. So that's those two. So far, you see the transformation. So this is supposed to fit you really well. And I did used to actually very much like these, and I used them up as much as I could before I got my new foundation. So this one's 110. This was one of the lighter ones I got. I think I also have a 120. I think maybe when I was a little bit tanner or something like that. I might not be able to get a lot from this, which is a shame because I need a good comparison. Might be okay, I guess. We'll see. We'll squirt it on, pump it onto the top of this time though, so you can see the color of it. This is porcelain. This is my MakeSense Advanced Anti-Aging Foundation. It has CenaShield and Cineplex. We'll get into that. Here's my special brush I like using. Look at that drastic difference. All those went on completely different color. This came on yellow. This is yellow. This is a yellow foundation on me. And you know what? I was really scared at first. I was like, there's no way this is going to be a good color for me. Better be careful. I'm going over the line a little bit. I'm getting a little excited. But I promise you, when it goes on, it looks so good on me. I couldn't be happier with this color. I might have put a little much for the side because that's a whole pump that I normally use for the majority of my face. I like to just pat it. Okay. Wow. So I'm going to show you guys a few drastic, or a few, not drastic, but a few before and afters that I think are pretty amazing with foundation.
We've got this lady right here who used, I'm going to show you a picture. She used the Tan Makes Sense foundation. And you see the difference from there. And there's a lot of other Cetogens products that she used as well to help with all that. But just look at that difference. And then next, we have this young lady with very, very light skin like mine who used. What she used? She used Fawn. Like, she has a few blemishes. But to go from there to there with the Fawn, it's very nice. So then let's check out this next young lady who used. She's very freckly, like me, and a little bit of discoloration, whatever you want to call it. Discoloration, just where, the coloration, on your face is a little uneven. Mine's like that as well. She used Dewy, which I hear is a very popular shade that people use. It tends to work for a lot of people. And here's this last lady I'm going to show you, which I think is a wonderful transformation. It doesn't tell you which shade she uses, but you can tell she's got an acne problem, and look at how well our foundation covers that. What a transformation. We have Adobe Almond Beige. Why is this just all on? Oh, this is an advanced anti-aging. Anyways. Adobe Almond, Beige Chiffon, Café au Lait, Cinnamon, Coffee, Cream Beige, Deep Caramel, Dewy, Fawn, Golden Tan, Ivory, which was the other color that was actually the shade that I was suggested based off of my veins, and I'll tell you about that in just a second. The pearlizer, which is just something that can give you a healthy glow, and I'll show you what that looks like here in just a second as well. Porcelain, which is what I'm wearing. Suede, tan, truffle, and that is it. At 16, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's 9 shades in the Make Sense foundation. There's 16 in the entire Advanced anti-aging. That's pretty wordy. You know what I just realized? I'm just gonna sit here and say at the bullet points, but I'm probably just going to type all this and put it in the description. There you go. So you don't have to listen to me read it. Now I'm gonna show you what I do have because I have a few samples. So here, what you're gonna see, this very glowy right here is the pearlizer. So you can use that as a highlight. You can use that, put that into your foundation. When you pump it as like a healthy glow is what a lot of people do. This is almond right here. This is café au lait. And these actually show up really well on my very pale skin. This is fawn. This of course is porcelain. And this is suede. And they've all dried very nicely. So it's amazing to see the difference between all of that. I can't describe it. I know right now it looks incredibly out of place. It looks like it does not go on my face. Like it probably just should not. And part of that is probably because I put a little too much on this side. But no, like it's just so weird. But do you see the difference in all the foundations? I mean, you saw that in the before video. You saw it. So it's so weird to see it like this. But I like the coverage it has. It takes away a lot of the redness. It covers underneath the eye really well, even though I still put the Sandstone Pearl as like my concealer. Under eye concealer. And so that was one of the things that I was supposed to talk about was the way you're supposed to choose, and I'll put it here. Foundation match cheat sheet. So you've got warm and you've got cool and you've got neutral. How to find your skin's undertone. You are either cool, warm, or neutral. Take a closer look at the veins on the underside of your wrist. So, if you, let's see right here, if you can see, I have blue and purple veins. Are they blue or purple? If so, then you are cool and will look good in mixed shades with pink or red undertones, ivory, almond, chestnut, cafe au lait, mahogany, and mink.
Ivory was the lightest in suggesting for cool, but for some reason I still felt like it was going to be too,
Yes, Charlie.
I felt like it was still going to be too brownish or like too dark. I thought it was going to be too dark, so I went out on a limb and went with porcelain. And at first I didn't like it, but I love it. I absolutely love it now. So
That's how you tell. If you have green or olive, then you are warm, and they will look great with mixed scent shades with yellow undertones like porcelain, or cream beige, beige chiffon, tan, suede, and fawn. If you can't quite tell, then you are neutral, and dewy will most likely look
best on you, which a lot of people use dewy. So even though this is meant for a warm tone, it still color matches to me. I'm fine with that. I love it. So hopefully this was an interesting video, something different. Tried to be as informative as I could be as well, and just wanted to play around with the stuff and see the difference of all the foundations that I've had throughout the years with the one that I'm using currently. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I have tons of other videos kind of like this, you know, makeup videos. I have cover songs, I have gameplays and vlogs and other stuff that you might be interested in. So, stick around for tons of other cool things, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Bye!